keep its magic. Then little bee sang my way out of one against a day. So I left its magic. And I wish I wasn't so scared of something so small that kept me from moving forward. And I wish I would come.
How are you guys doing? So, just reminding you guys, this is usually the entrance to a parking garage. This is totally a magical space, and what makes it magical is, of course, all of this infrastructure that was put in, but it's also an opportunity to share in a unique way.
But there's one thing that you better know. Singing a brand new song of mine called Stay with these wonderful, wonderful string players in the New York Philharmonic.
Yes!
We're going to do now, I should talk a little bit about the concept for tonight. You know, both Nick and I, we've done a lot of shows together, and we share a similar aesthetic and a similar penchant for blending styles and trying to find compelling connections between classical and popular repertoire, and also trying to cross-pollinate in the disciplines, if you will. So not only will we hear a blend of popular song with classical or symphony, and I would say we are in the lineage of two previous music directors of the orchestra from which they come, Gustav Mahler and Leonard Bernstein, and sharing that idea of combining popular song with symphony and symphonic qualities. But again, you know, you see this kind of elaborate keyboard setup. We'll be combining different techniques in the disciplines. So the idea of taking electronic music and then injecting that into classical is something I'm very interested in. You're going to hear that in this next piece, which is as yet unnamed, but we call it E minor, if you're keeping track. Or if you have perfect pitch. So here it is.
Thank you.
Heartbreak. I wrote it after I realized that he had moved on, and so you see all the pictures on social media, or you see the comments, and you could just put two and two together. And so the first thought I had was, oh, God forbid I don't meet her. I mean, like, I don't know what's gonna happen. Nothing's gonna happen. I'm a really nice person, but what's that gonna be emotionally? And so I spent the whole day crying and wrote this song in one sitting. I met her and it was fine.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I did. Eventually. 2 years later.
So sorry for her.
Yeah, she sucks. So this is God Forbid. I'm putting it out next month. So stay tuned if you like it. Two clicks in a minute, one or two minutes, you wish I had been. I'm stuck in scrolling through, and I know she knew what to do. Thank you.
God forbid I ever meet her. Hope you never bring her around. God forbid I ever meet her. She won't know she broke her down. Don't you ever let me meet her. Ooh, yeah, she'll remind me of everything I wouldn't give to let you.
Made a boy that I
Cookies, you do.
Thank you.
ago, and I wrote it last year during the race riots, everything that was happening in the U.S. and abroad. I think the lyrics pretty much speak for themselves, but when I thought about it, I felt like at its core we're just really lacking empathy, and that was my big question. How hard is it to show me empathy? It's nothing different between us, but apparently there is, because this has been going on for centuries. But I hope that, I'm sure everybody in this crowd is kind of on the same page, but my hope was that this song would change somebody's perspective on things, maybe provide a little bit of hope, but also encourage change, because that's what needs to happen. But anyways, this song is called Human. It's out on all the distribution platforms. I can't speak. And there's also a music video online. Words aren't enough.
India Carney, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight has been a true blessing to share the stage with this incredible artist and to hear these songs of hers, which are pretty new. So it's amazing to hear that. It's amazing to share this stage with Nick Kendall and then my new friends here from the New York Philharmonic. What a tremendous, tremendous job they have done on this music, and it's such a pleasure to share this stage. We've been blown away all week by their artistry, so it's been truly special. I'm going to bring back the curator of this event, the reason that we're all together here tonight, my good friend, Mr. Nick Kendall.
No. Okay, we're going to do one more song, but I just wanted to, I don't want to talk too much, but I do want to put names to faces of our amazing musicians from the New York Phil. That's Xiong Ji. Over here, give it up for Xiong Ji. This is Shen Shen. She's in the first violin section. That's a team, y'all. She is principal second of the team of New York Phil, right? Sung Wu over here on viola, everybody. And Nathan Vickery, right here on cello. And the reason why I wanted to say their names is because everything that I've imagined about this series, Continuum at Lincoln Center, is about drawing out from the musical community. I feel so blessed to know so many incredible artists. For me, I don't care about genre. I just don't. All I care about is if you make me feel something. And if you make me feel something, then that feeling gets put out, and then if there's an audience of one person, 5 people, 1,000 people, that energy comes right back. And we feel it as people, we feel it as artists. And these individuals are usually in a big mass that is our incredible New York Philharmonic, but I wanted to pull them out because first of all, I get to be friends with them. But second of all, it's a chance for them to shine and add to the energy. There's going to be many more years of collaborations like this for me to be able to bring in India Carney, who the world has got to know over the couple years. She's amazing. And again, there are many great singers out there. There are many great singers. But for me, it's beyond that. It's beyond the words. It's if you feel something from an artist in India does that. And of course, for me to be able to open my series down here at Jaffe Drive, for the music to exist and put it all together, it wouldn't be possible without my dear friend, longtime friend and collaborator, Mr. Steve Hackman, right back. Thank you for sharing this evening, guys. We're gonna play one more song, but then we're gonna put our instruments back. There's gonna be drinking, I think. There's like an hour more. You guys are too young. Do you have wristbands? You don't have wristbands. Bartender, if you can't see them over the bar, then they're, okay. But we'd love to mingle with you, have conversations. All of us are gonna come out and we can share ideas. And Steve, what is this next thing we're gonna do, this last thing?
I feel like just being candid is appropriate right now. So we were gonna play another original song, and it was gonna feature a good artist, great artist friend of mine, a rapper, but he had to be still in LA. So on the plane ride here a couple nights ago, it was just occurring to most of us that this song wasn't gonna make too much sense without his presence. So what would make sense, however, in my mind at least, on the 11 o'clock plane ride was, instead of doing the song, superimposing the Bee Gees' Stayin' Alive on top of the song. So, yeah, so it's, that's right, that's right. Yeah, that's a reaction about I expected.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
yeah, so it's the music of another song, but adapted over top is the Bee Gees' Stayin' Alive. And we'll see how important that is. Well, nope, it's not working if you guys just flood to the bar.
Good track. Thank you.
okay.